Oh no, the camera is running out of battery and I don't know where the charger is, but hello everyone, welcome back to a new vlog. I'm gonna do a last night with the family, because I didn't want to vlog the family holiday, because you know, it's everyone's holiday, it's not just mine. I don't want to be shoving a camera in their face, so I thought I'd do the last night, because I'm leaving them tomorrow morning. I'm leaving the island, and I'm going back to England for 2 days, a day and a half, to get ready, because we're going for dinner in like half an hour, and I look like this. I don't want to take it out. This is my bathroom. Should I do it at all? I don't want to get copyright, because my brother's playing music. But guys, it's a mess. What? And I'm kind of packing, but look at this view. Wow, wow. So this is my bedroom. I apologize sincerely for that mess. Packing, again, mess. And then this is the balcony, the top balcony. And this island is called Korčula. It's in Croatia. It is about an hour and a half ferry from Dubrovnik. When you fly into Dubrovnik, you can get a ferry straight from there to here, or it is about a 2.5 or 3 hour ferry from Split. But I went to Hvar, obviously you saw the vlog before here, and it was only an hour on the ferry from there, which was great. But yeah, it's just gorgeous. That's the pool down there. It's been a bit cloudy today, but actually no, massive cloud there. But it's still actually quite warm, which is really good. The wind's died down. And we're going to Mimi's tonight, which is a restaurant just around the bay from us, owned by one of our friends on the island. And she is lovely and the food is amazing. If you're actually looking for a place to stay in Korčula, if you don't want to book this Villa Opus, then stay at Tara's Lodge. It's gorgeous. That's the same place as Mimi's, but that's the hotel part. Anyway, pretty view. Sad to be leaving tomorrow, but I'm on to my next adventure. I am going to Portugal. I haven't really been to Portugal. I went when I was tiny and I don't remember it, so I'm very excited to explore. I'm going back to England for Wednesday, then fly Thursday morning. Got a lot to do in London. Fresh out of the shower. Oh, it's so nice showering after a day in the sun. Well, I'd say in the sun, but actually it wasn't that sunny today. My skin has been so dry whilst I've been on holiday because of the stuff I use on my skin for my spots, like my acne stuff. It's been so dry. So I have used this Global Protection Day Cream by Ren, and it's actually been a lifesaver because it's not oily, so it's like doesn't break you out, but it's super hydrating. 3, 2, 1. Makeup is done, hair is straightened. So now I'm going to choose my outfit for this evening. I've actually basically packed everything, but I left out my sturdy Zara dress that I wear all the time, because it's just, I need to squeeze out for the rest of summer, you know. We've only got, well, literally today, and then I don't think I'll take it to Portugal. But I also want to get a photo in this yellow crochet set. Do I have time? What's the time? I don't have time. We're leaving basically now. Bear with me, I'm just going to quickly get my dress on. Oh, I'm wearing something I haven't worn in about a year and a half. I got rings back, I got my back, I got a changing back, I got a nephew back, I got a...
It's a YouTube video.
Say hi.
It's a YouTube video.
Hey, Dad. Hey, Matt. Look at the sky. That's wow. Oh, it's not quite picking up on the old camera, is it?
No.
Wow.
That's not bad.
And Matthew! Nelly!
Yo!
Go on, sis, where's your outfit from?
This is from Matt's wardrobe.
Matt, this would look stunning on you.
I've had this for so many years, and it's got a little hole for my tail. Yes.
Lovely! She looks stunning.
Haven't worn it in a long time.
OOTD?
Babies from her.
Half of you, half of her.
Birkenstocks are from Birkenstock, and the tops from Mango.
Ooh, Dad OOTD.
I got my whole outfit from Mother Care.
Every time.
It's always funny. From Mother Care. And then I'm wearing my Zara dress. I actually wore.
What are you wearing?
story. Is that what
thanks,
you
guys.
Want
to tell us? I actually wore it at Ray's baby shower. And now she's here. Right, let me take a photo of you, sis. Currently at dinner at Mimi's. We have ordered
truffle
pasta. We're looking
at a cinnamon swirl on the back of her head.
Oh,
wait, there.
Oh,
it's like a little cinnamon.
Look at her little outfit. So cute.
Her little nappy popped out.
Wait.
But we have ordered truffle pasta.
Fettuccine.
Fettuccine, homemade fettuccine with truffle, and it was it sounds delicious, and
it looks
delicious. What I was going to say is we had a starter which was tuna tartare, and it was.
Where are we, Bron?
Where are we?
Tara's Lodge. If you're in Cortula, come here. Mimi's.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. Yeah.
So pretty. And it's right on the... Henry, say hi.
Come on,
Henry. Hey, guys. So, did you fall off in front of the camera? Yeah, really.
Have you done something?
We're right on the waterfront as well. It's honestly gorgeous. And you can paddleboard, canoe, everything off it. It's beautiful. So my baby keeps coming out in his dress. It's really cute.
Oh, there.
We've got our truffle pasta.
Matt's got his both.
We're doing a taste test.
When he came with our crew, we got absolutely hammered one night. And I said, here are my kids.
That is phenomenal.
It's the homemade pasta for me.
It's al dente as well.
Oh, look at her. She's got it all over her mouth. Al dente. Oh my gosh, that is.
That's better than sex. You get to drive. I was like, there is no way I can drive.
Did you hear your future wife to be? Interview with Matthew Carter.
Am I getting paid for this?
Yeah. Swipe off.
Okay.
So, what is your favourite thing about my sis?
At the moment, it's Orno. This is a PG version.
18.
Yeah.
My favourite thing. It's the mother that she's become.
That was really lovely.
People will react to that. Like, oh, it's really sweet. Oh, God, he's wet.
No. Because I thought you were going to say something inappropriate.
I did think of that. I was going to say about what's happened to your breasts.
What's your favourite thing about me?
Your fashion sense.
Matt, that's so kind. My favourite thing about Matthew is his love for food.
His love for food. Excellent for saying that, though. We've been away for a couple of weeks. And your mum's food is great, but it's no Greg sausage roll.
Yeah.
We eat a bit too well here.
We eat very well. Very, very healthy.
Sausage roll. Greg sausage roll.
This is your secret.
I went
to the
loan.
Oh, you can't fault me. I think because we're quite similar.
Yeah, Matthew and I are similar.
Food taste,
We're, what do you call it, salt and pepper.
Salt and pepper. You're my pasty.
And I'm your filling. Sausage roll.
You're my sausage roll pasty.
You're the pastry.
No, you're the pasty. Oh, sorry, pasty.
Yeah.
And you're the
pastry. I was about to say, you're the pastry that wraps my sausage. Finish there.
That's how we made a radio.
That'll do, YouTube.
Oh, I'm going to repeat that on your wedding day. Guys, I made it to the plane. Bit of drama that I don't want to pick up the camera for because I had loads of people around, and she didn't think it was appropriate. So, woke up, alarm went off at 6:25 this morning. I don't think I can take my mask off to explain. Went to go and get the ferry at 7 a.m. and it didn't turn up. So we were standing at the port and they were like, sorry, the ferry's not coming. I was like, I've got a flight to catch in about 3 hours, and it takes 2 hours on the ferry and 2 hours to get there anyway. So I had to jump in this taxi with the Swedish couple, and there's loads of people coming on the plane. And the taxi took about 2 hours, and it was the windiest roads. I was trying to concentrate on not being sick, so I didn't pick up the camera because they were in the back as well. But the taxi driver was so lovely, and he got me there on time. I just passed through security. There was no one there. It was amazing. And now I'm on the flight. We haven't taken off yet. We're still in Croatia. But yeah, I'm feeling good, even though I don't like flying, but I feel fine. I will keep you guys updated. I'm going to try and edit some of this vlog on here, and hopefully I've got some nice people sitting next to me so I can have a little chat. And I've got some little snacks that I picked up in the airport. Anyway, I made it, I'm safe. London, I should be with you in about 2.5 hours. I made it back home. Oh my God, it's actually so nice to be back. I have been unpacking, washing, just getting everything together, getting like work stuff done and like packed, ready for Portugal. And now I'm off for ZZ's, of course, with Charlotte. And I've got dressed up. I mean, I'm wearing long sleeves and a jacket over the top because England's cold. England's very cold. I'm actually running late, so I need to get my shoes on, but I'm gonna bring you along to ZZ's, and I'll update you all there because I'm in a bit of a rush, but I'm gonna jump on the train. Guys, I'm just on the bridge trying to find Charlotte. Maybe we're on the wrong side. I don't know if I'm on the wrong side or not. Charlotte.
Bloody day.
Happy
also,
bloody day.
That Uber boat thing made this like big beep noise. The room of boats.
Charlotte, I
haven't got my tea key.
Oh, I've got my mine, strap on. Mine does keep coming off, but it's alright. I do look tired.
Yeah.
The eyes are really weeping. So we made it to ZZ. We got turned away from the Covent Garden one, which was a bit annoying, but it's alright. We didn't make a booking. Who knew ZZ's was so popular in London? And then we're in the, where are we? Like, what's this area called?
St. Giles.
St. Giles, but
it's like near Tottenham Court Road.
Yeah. It was only 8 minute walk from Covent Garden, so it was absolutely fine. And we have
also,
ordered.
What's so funny is like, this is the one that's right next to my, like, this is so close to the office. Like, I've done a massive move.
Is it?
Loop. Yeah. At least I've got some
steps in. Yeah, she got a steps in. So we have both ordered calzone, which we've never had from ZZ's before, so we'll let you know how that is. And garlic bread, olives,
garlic bread,
olives, and then this is 5 cheeses in one pot, and then Charlotte's waiting for her mozzarella with garlic bread. Garlic bread with mozzarella.
The one, the only.
Gosh, the name's coming off now. This gets you £200 every time you come to ZZ's, and it expires on the 31st of December this year. So we're trying to make the most of it. I land and I come straight to ZZ. We finished our dins and we've got our own little goodie bags because we couldn't finish our calzone, so we put it in a doggy bag. What do we rate this one?
That is a good question. I'd say if we're giving Covent Garden a 9, I reckon that was a 7.
Yeah, maybe 7.5 because the interior really blew me away.
Yeah, I had actually accounted for that.
And the toilets, we got to add up the
I didn't
toilets.
Really like the toilets. Well, the one on the right on the end didn't have a lock.
Did
it's
it
like
not?
Fallen off, oh. So it's a bit like prison cell
vibes. I couldn't flush the toilet.
Oh, from the city!
I pushed
city.
So hard!
It wouldn't
do it. Honestly, I was pushing so hard and I was like,
if anyone went to ZZ and saw something in the lorry, I was run to.
I was like, my acrylic was about to ping off, so I was like, okay. But yeah, that was the one in St. Giles, Central St. Giles. It's like near Tottenham Court Road. And if you're looking for like a date night ZZ's, I think that's quite a nice date night ZZ's.
Also, it's quite, if you're looking to go on a date where you might not see anyone that you know.
ZZ's.
Well, yeah, ZZ's, but also that ZZ's because genuinely it was dead. Like it was us and maybe 6 other people in there. The whole of the restaurant.
Good morning, everyone. Well, it's not even morning. It's 11:30. It's morning. I've just been running around trying to get everything done. I've just had a meeting, which was really good, really exciting. Just loads going on. I'm going to do my makeup, so I need to shoot a photo for a very, very exciting giveaway, which is going up on my Instagram page, guys. It's the biggest thing, the biggest giveaway I've ever done. Like, just go over and find it, at Bronte King Double G. And then I'm going for lunch. Then I'm going to get my nails done, and then I need to pack and get ready for my flight tomorrow morning. So that's why I haven't picked up the camera. I literally fell asleep last night at, like, 9 o'clock, woke up at 4 a.m. like, where am I? I was so confused, I really didn't know where I was. And then went back to sleep and I was like, oh, it's so nice to be in London. Honestly, I've missed it so much. I didn't realise I had, but I really had. It's probably because it's so sunny today. It's literally amazing. So yeah, I'm gonna get ready. I want to show you guys this because you know when you come off holiday and you've got the tan, you don't want to put foundation on and take away the tan. So this is the Radiance Booster by Iconic London, and it's amazing, like, for when you come off holiday. And I'm actually going to take it to Portugal as my foundation. And it's just such a nice base. I think it's meant to be like a, can be thrown either alone or under foundation for the next generation glow. But I love it. It's such a nice colour. So yeah, I'm going to go get ready because I need to take some pics. I have been the most awful vlogger in the whole world today. Shock horror. Charlotte's in my flat.
Our flat now.
It's basically the Bronte and Charlotte show.
I got my nails done.
Oh, it's just focusing on you. Got my nails done at Absolute Joy Spa. If you're looking for somewhere to go in Southwest London, I really recommend. She said, do you want like strawberries or cherries or anything to add a bit of fun? And I was like, do you know what? Let's add a little heart. So I did that. I went and saw Amzy T for Joe and the Juice. And now I'm packing and I've overpacked, haven't I?
Yeah, she needs me to have a little bit of a...
Yeah, oh, I just can't be bothered. I just want to take everything. Maybe I'll go on, I might go on EasyJet and ask if I can have some extra, as in like book extra luggage.
What, or another bag?
No, not another bag. Imagine me turning up.
What weight do you get?
For two bags. They'd literally be like, how long are you staying for? I might go on and see if I can get 26 kg instead of 23. Because it's more expensive at the airport when you actually check your bag in, isn't it, than online.
Yeah, apparently that's what they said
last time. Yeah, I remember I went to Lanzarote with Amber and they charged us £80 per kg. We were over. And I was over by 3 kg and I had to pay £80 each kg. It was awful. Anyway, this is the packing so far. And we're literally full to the brim. Like, there is no more going in there. So I've put all my toiletries in there, my makeup, some trainers. Yeah, I've got some parcels to return. And I'm going to cook myself a salmon stir fry this evening because I haven't cooked for ages.
Are you going to have that salmon TikTok thing?
No, I'm not tonight, but I will try it. Have you tried it? No.
You're asking the camera. No. I always feel like it's some sort of like live thing, like, Hi guys. No, I haven't. But I actually, when I was in Wasabi yesterday, they have like basically a thing that's that exact thing.
What? Really?
They've got this little like seaweed triangle thing.
Oh. I've had that.
Is it nice?
Yeah, really nice.
Because it says cooked salmon.
Yeah.
And then all of the sauces that are in that.
Yeah, I had it the other day and it was really nice, although it felt...
Oh, bless you.
It fell all over me on the train, so I had soy sauce all going down me, which was really cute. But yeah, I'm going to make it in Portugal. Buy all the ingredients.
Oh, guys, isn't it sad that it's going away for so long?
Don't worry, I won't be away for that long.
Who is it?
Had to explain. Someone that Charlotte met at the festival, a boy that Charlotte met at the festival, messaged her being like, oh, I didn't know this was you, and it was my YouTube video of Havar. Yeah. Well, at least it's coming up on his YouTube.
It was actually really awkward because he kept messaging me, like, asking me what I've been up to, and I keep ignoring him. And then he sent me the link, and he's like, now I know what you've been doing. Oh,
stalker.
I was like, okay.
Weird that it came up.
I think that's yeah. Really, very strange.
Why would my Havar vlog, my birthday vlog, come up on a boy's?
It must be a YouTube search from Instagram or something. Like, that wouldn't come up on a boy, I just don't think. Unless he is maybe going to Havar.
Oh, yeah, unless he's typed in, like, Havar recommendations.
Yeah.
Bronte Yang, here with the recommendations. Morning, guys. It's, like, 6:20 in the morning. I woke up at 4:30 in the morning because it was a loud noise outside, and then my body clock is, like, early at the moment, and I just haven't been able to get back to sleep, so I've been up since 4:30 this morning. I'm just about to leave for the station now. I'm so excited. So suitcase is all packed, managed to get everything in it. The hand luggage is literally about to burst open. Outfit, this hoodie, how amazing, handmade by Kate Customs on Instagram. She is a magician. She's amazing. She's made me a top before and obsessed. So this is a little white hoodie. And then we've got these trackies from ASOS. They're a little bit big, but they're comfy. And then she's got my Nike Air Force ones on, and then I've got my leather jacket on the floor that needs to be picked up. Off I go to the airport. Guys, I haven't updated you since I left the flat. I'm up in the air. my way to Portugal, but me, myself and I, I don't have a room to myself this time. I have a lady sitting on the aisle seat, but that's alright. I'm in the same seat as I was on the way back from Dubrovnik. So yeah, you can edit this vlog. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video. Wish me luck on my flight, and I will be vlogging in Portugal, so stay tuned.